Sure. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear students, we will discuss today forensic psychiatry. Forensic psychiatry is a subject, or it's a subspeciality, you can say it's a subspeciality of psychiatry which deals forensically. It means, as the definition of forensic medicine is, that the application of medical knowledge to the purpose of law. So forensic psychiatry is a subject which provides medical knowledge and forensic knowledge, or forensic psychiatric knowledge, to the purpose of law. So we will discuss in different steps. Now, definition of forensic psychiatry: mental disorders of forensic importance. How to differentiate between true and feigned insanity. Procedure of restraint of mentally ill. Limitations to civil and criminal responsibilities of a mentally ill. Now, forensic psychiatry application of psychiatric knowledge to legal issues. Now, meaning by, when you apply psychiatric knowledge to the purpose of law, how they increase or decrease the punishment regarding psychiatric illness of the accused. So, by meaning that application forensic psychiatry is a subspecialty of psychiatry which deals with the application of psychiatric knowledge to legal issues. Now, mental disorders of the forensic importance. Two main categories of mental disorders are where there is no loss of contact with reality. Dear student, you say where there is no loss of contact with reality, means no loss of contact with reality. You should have contact with the reality. Means by, just for example, when there is a reality behind something, like there is a fixed time for azan. For example, I am explaining, like, for example, like azan is over at 12:45. It's a fixed time with some minutes either way. But when you heard azan at midnight, means there is no reality behind your contact. Ab main aur aasan lafz mein samjhaun, no loss of contact with the reality. Matlab ke ek azan ka fixed time hai, jab hum wo azan aadhi raat ko sunte hain, hamare kaano mein aisi awaaz aati hai, to ye ek tarah ka kya hai, loss of contact. Or the fixed time hai with azan, it's, there is no loss of contact with reality. Isko aur elaborate kare ki ek psychological illness jisme kuch, there is some solid material behind that. Again, solid material means, if there is psychiatric illness due to some inborn defect, some acquired defects, some mentally ill patients like schizophrenic or like the person having some psychiatric illness or which are inborn errors, when inborn, you can say inborn defects like Down syndrome. So such context, there is some reality behind the psychological reaction of a person. Then the second part is disorders where the there is loss of contact with reality and symptoms, like delusions and hallucinations. Now we will explain it further, delusion and hallucination, just to understand this. Loss of contact. जैसे मैंने आपको पहले बताया कि अजान की आवाज़ एक फिक्स टाइम है, जब वो फिक्स टाइम से लहदा आएगी, मीन्स कि उसका एक रियलिटी के साथ कोई ताल्लुक नहीं है. देर इज लॉस ऑफ कॉन्टेक्ट विद रियलिटी. ऐसी चीज़ों को जो हमें ऐसी चीज़ें फील होंगी, हम महसूस करेंगे, जिनका हकीकत के साथ कोई ताल्लुक नहीं है. दैट आर disorders like delusions and hallucinations. Now this will be explained further in the next slides. Delusions. Dear student, delusions are false and form belief that are contrary to the fact. Just to try to understand, form and false belief. एक पक्का यकीन किसी गलत बात का, गलत और पक्का यकीन किसी ऐसी बात का जिसका वजूद के साथ, हकीकत के साथ कोई ताल्लुक नहीं है. For example, believing that you are somebody else. जैसे आप अपने आप को, आपको पक्का यकीन है कि आप जीसस क्राइस्ट हो, यू आर प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ अ कंट्री, यू आर सपोज टू बी, नॉट सपोज, यू कैन से यू बिलीव, यू हैव फर्म बिलीव विच इज फॉल्स ऑल्सो, दैट यू आर प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ अमेरिका. This is a psychological defect. It's called delusions. So delusions are false and firm beliefs that are contrary to the fact. And it has different types. Erotomanic delusions, that another person, usually of higher status, is in love with the individuals. अब इसके एग्जांपल हम ऐसे कहेंगे कि कोई एक, आप एक बंदा फील करता है कि मेरा जर्मनी के जर्मन चांसलर के साथ बहुत मेरे साथ लव करती है, या कोई ऐसा खातून जिसके साथ, अगर मेल है, मेल की बात करूंगा, कि वो फॉल्स इन लव विद सम इंडिविजुअल विच इज फार अवे फ्रॉम हिम, देयर इज नो कॉन्टेक्ट. So this type is called erotomanic delusions. Now the delusion of grandiose, of inflated worth, to have contact with, relationship to a famous persons, to a person of very high rank, like example is like that. You people, a simple man assumes that he has very good relation with Trump, Donald Trump. His good relation with Putin, which is actually no. There is, you know, again understand, there is loss of contact with the reality. Now third one, jealous, delusion of jealousy. This type of deviant makes many crimes, many honor killings, that once due to its psychological defect, one's sexual partner is unfaithful. Your sexual partner, like a person's wife, is having contact with some other person. So this type of deviant makes a crime. When many honor killings are due to this type of deviant. Now, deviant of persecutory, that one is being attacked, cheated, or conspired against. Just try to understand, persecutory is somebody is behind you. अब इसे कहते हैं कि कोई बंदा मुझे मारना चाहता है, ये मेरे खिलाफ मुझे भड़का रहा है, किसी को कोई मुझे मारना चाहता है, कोई मुझे अटैक करना चाहता है, हालांकि वो उसका कोई तल्लक ही नहीं है. देर इज नो कॉन्टेक्ट विद द हिस्ट्री, देर इज नो कॉन्टेक्ट विद द रियलिटी. एंड दिस मे लीड टू सम सॉर्ट ऑफ क्राइम्स. Then somatic, soma, just like the physical defects, whose main content pertains to appearance or function of one's body. Means bodily functions which create some psychological problem. Meaning by whose main content pertains to appearance of or functions of one's body. मीन्स कोई बंदा एक नेकेड आदमी फिर रहा है और वो उसको दे डोंट हैव सेंस बॉडीली, वो न्यूट, लेकिन उसका इफेक्ट उस पर क्या आएगा, मुआशरा डिस्टर्ब होगा, साइकोलॉजिकल हर्ट होगा, हरासमेंट, सेक्सुअल हरासमेंट होगी. तो ये सारी चीजें कम्स अंडर द डिलीवियन ऑफ सोमैटिक डिलीवियन. Now mixed type of psychological defect contains, उसमें क्या हम कहेंगे illusions, उस example illusions, an actual external stimulus, it is contrary to the delusion, there is no contact with the reality, and in this an actual external stimulus is misperceived or misinterpreted. For example, stick may be perceived as snake. बच्चों गर्मियों में आपने जाते सड़क पे देखा होगा मौसम में से कि आप गाड़ी में जा रहे हैं तो दूर आगे आपको नजर आएगा पानी, but it is actually not. सड़क को आप पानी perceive कर रहे हो. These are called illusions. Clear? कि वो चीज एक्चुअली है लेकिन हम उसको मिसपरसीव कर रहे हैं, मिस इंटरप्रेट कर रहे हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड इल्यूजन्स. नाउ कम टू द हेलुसिनेशन. दैट डिल्यूजन मींस फॉल्स एंड फर्म बिलीफ ऑन समथिंग विच इज कॉन्ट्रेरी टू द ट्रूथ. But in hallucinations, there is abnormal sensory experience that arises in the absence of a direct external stimulus. Hallucination may occur in any sensory modality. Now, understand this. Abnormal sensory experience that arises in the absence of a direct external stimulus. अब इसकी एग्जाम्पल मैं दूंगा, कोई ऐसी चीज आप परसीव कर रहे हो जो मतलब मैं उसकी सिंपल के आपको एक कहते हैं जी ये मुझे भूत नजर आ रहा है. भूत मीन कि कुछ ऐसे साए नजर आ रहे हैं जो है ही नहीं, या आपके कानों में अजान की आवाज आ रही है जो उसका टाइम ही नहीं है. You perceive something which is contrary to the truth, right? Now, there are types of hallucinations: auditory hallucinations, visual hallucinations, tactile hallucinations, olfactory hallucinations, gustatory and somatic hallucinations. So they are concerned with the five senses. Now, first, auditory hallucination, by the name evident, which you listen, you perceive some sounds which have no contact with the reality, like voice of azan at midnight, voice of some music which is not present there. So it's a perception, some which is feel you hear, which is not present actually. Now, the visual hallucinations concerned with the VN involve sight, which may consist of formed images such as of people or of unformed images, flashes of light. Yeah, you can say कि आपको different चीजें नजर आती हैं जो के एक बंदा कह रहा है जो मुझे ये नजर आ रहा है मुझे ये नजर आ रहा है मुझे चुड़ैल नजर आ रही है ये नजर आ रहा है हालांकि ये there is no such truth is there. Now, tactile, touch with touch, involves the perception of being touched or something being under one's skin. The most common tactile hallucinations are the sensation of electric shocks and fornication. Fornication means the sensation of something creeping or crawling on or under the skin. It's you will learn it, you will again see this in tactile hallucination. Cocaine poisoning. There is feeling of something crawling or creeping under the skin. This is called tactile hallucination, which is again try to say there's no sense of truth is there. It's just a feeling. You see something is crawling or creeping under or on the skin of your body. Then olfactory involves the perception of odors such as burning rubber or decaying fish. This type of sensation is taken as olfactory hallucinations. Then gustatory, the touch with the mistouch, as you can say the other feelings which are not actually present on the taste buds. Unpleasant taste, you say you taking sugar but you feel that it's very bitter, that's against the truth. Somatic, then the last one, somatic hallucinations, which involves the perception of a physical experience localized within the body, such as a feeling of electricity. You can say there's something flashing inside the body, something going on in your brain, something going on in your heart, which is actually not. Now it's clear about the hallucinations and delusions. Now we will come to the point that difference between true and feigned mental illness. First we will see whether it is a mental illness or not. Is a person you are going to face is mentally ill or just feigning? Feigning means bravat, jhootapan, yani actually nahi hai wo, lekin wo mentally ill apne aap ko show kar raha hai to get some relief from the court, just to agree some relief from the punishment. So there are different points we will consider to differentiate between true and feigned insanity. So the purpose for this slide, that first you will know whether it is his or she is actually insane or just try to become an insane to get the relief from the court. So there are different points. First, the onset. True insanity usually gradual or rarely sudden, but almost always without any motive. But in feigned insanity, always sudden and not without some motive. बच्चों बात समझ आएगी इसकी कि जो true insanity है वो based on history. They have some causative agent behind that. But in feigned insanity, what happens? कि वो कोशिश करता है कि मैं ऐसी चीज शो करूं कि जो मैं लगूं कि मैं आई एम इनसेन, लेकिन वो है नहीं. ठीक है, वो एकदम सडन अपीयर करता है अपने को. एक बंदा अच्छा भला चल रहा है, एकदम वो अपने आप को जैसे टांग उठा के, जैसे आम लोग आप देखते हो फकीर चल रहे हैं, तो वो शो करने के लिए फौरी तौर पे बाजू अंदर छुपा लेगा, मेरा एक बाजू ही नहीं है, एक टांग इकट्ठी कर लेगा, मेरी टांग ही नहीं है. सो दैट विल बी अ सडन बिहेवियर चेंज. बट इन इनसेन, ट्रू इनसेन, इट्स ग्रेजुअल, इट्स टाइम पासिंग. देन सेकंड पॉइंट, प्री डिस्पोजिंग फैक्टर्स मीन्स विच आर यूजली प्रेजेंट इन द true insane and not present in the fiend insane. A predisposing factor means that there is some history of, you can say, a neglected child, a divorced lady, they have some psychological problem or some trauma, post-traumatic psychological disorders. But in fiend insane, there is nothing such like that. He or she will try to become insane. Then the facial expression, usually peculiar and well developed cases of insanity. अब इसमें बहुत आसान है कि आप एक आम आदमी और एक insane, जिसे हम कहते हैं mentally ill person, उसमें एक फर्क बड़ा क्लियरली आपको नजर आएगा. फर्क इसमें क्या होगा, उसका हुलिया, उसकी चेहरे पे लोक, मैसिएटेड लोक, या उसकी आंखें खुली हैं, मतलब उसके रेड आईज, कंजेस्टेड आईज, मुंह से उसके समथिंग इज कमिंग आउट, जिसे कहते हैं राल टपकना, ड्रिबलिंग ऑफ सलाइवा. दिस आर ए फेशियल एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ अ ट्रू इनसेन. लेकिन ये चीजें नॉट प्रेजेंट इन द फीड इनसेन. ही विल ट्राई टू प्रीटेंड लाइक दैट. देन द लुक, आप सब लोगों ने देखे होंगे डेफिनेट, कभी गौर किया हो तो देखें कि जो मेंटली इल पर्सन है वो, उसकी लुक ही आपको फील होगी कि देयर इज समथिंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल, जिसे कहते हैं खुला में घूरना, या उसका एजिटेटेड बिहेवियर, इरिटेटेड बिहेवियर, और हर बात पे वरिड, ये हो गया वो हो गया, ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए था. लेकिन ये सारी चीजें मौजूद नहीं होती है ना फीन इन चेन. देन मूड, mood of the of a mentally ill person is excited, depressed or fluctuating, may overact in insane person. In fiend insane may overact to show abnormality in mood. Yani wo ek si cheez hai nahi usme, lekin wo act kar raha hai usko show karne ke liye ki main ye, means jaise ki baazu hilai ja raha hai, tremble aa raha hai, to wo ट्रेमर्स करता रहेगा, लेकिन जब कोई आप देख रहे नजर उधर जाएगी तो वो ट्रेमर्स स्टॉप हो जाएंगे, जिसकी वजह से उसमें फटीग भी आएगी। लेकिन यही अगर मेंटली इल पर्सन है या ट्रू इनसेन है, उसमें ये चीजें नहीं होंगी। नाउ द साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स एंड ट्रू इनसेन यूजली पॉइंट्स टू अ पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ मेंटल इलनेस। द इंडिविजुअल शोज signs and symptom of insanity irrespective of his conduct being observed or not. तो वो हर चीज जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि उसके किसी के हाथ में ऐसे हाथ ट्रेमर्स लेके आ रहा है, वो जो मेंटली इल होगा उसमें ये सिम्टम ये चलती रहेगी, उसको नहीं उसमें डर ही नहीं क्योंकि देख रहा है कोई नहीं देख रहा, कैमरा देख रहा है या नहीं देख रहा। बट सच सिम्टम्स व्हेन यू विल ऑब्जर्व इन अ फीन इनसेन दैट आर नॉट यूनिफॉर्म and do not indicate any particular type of mental illness. The individual pretends to be insane only when he is observed. जब उसको देखेंगे तो वो उसकी वो हाथ में ट्रेमर शुरू हो जाएगा, जब भी आप उससे थोड़ा दूर होंगे तो वो ट्रेमर्स खत्म हो जाएंगे। And he is pretending to be a mentally ill person. There may be total absence of symptoms when he thinks that he is not being observed. Physical exhaustion, जैसे मैंने आपको पहले बताया था कि जो mentally ill person है उसको he is no he has no sense he is trying something which is contrary to the reality. He don't know about that. So, my friend के अगर उसे हाथ ट्रेमर उसमें तो वो करी जाएगा there will be no fatigue, okay? But when in a pain insane, वो कुछ अरसे बाद उसमें फटीक नजर आना शुरू हो जाएगी क्योंकि वो he knows cognitive function उसमें present properly, लेकिन insane में cognitive functions are reduced at lower level. Then physical manifestations, जो आपको जैसे मैंने पहले आपको बता चुका कि उसका face, vacant face, dry eyes, congested eyes, fur tongue, there may be constipation, anorexia, insomnia, and some other exhaustive conditions. But same are not present in the fiend a person, fiend insane person. So such the different habits and ye different signs and symptoms, they will prove whether he is mentally ill or trying to be a mentally ill. Now in when you see the habits, invariably dirty or filthy. आपने देखा होगा कि जो एक मलंग आदमी या जो मेंटली इल पर्सन है उसके नाम उसको कपड़ों का पता है, कपड़े गंदे हैं, फटे हैं तो फटे हुए हैं, बटन लगे हैं नहीं लगे, यही चीजें फीन इनसेन में, फीन इनसेनिटी में नॉट प्रेजेंट देयर। यू डिड नॉट डर्टी और फिल्थी दो अ फाइल्स शो मे बी पोस्ट टू दैट इफेक्ट। कोशिश करेगा ऐसे बनने की लेकिन वो नहीं बन सकता लाइक दैट ऑफ एन ओरिजिनल इनसेन। रिपीटेड एग्जामिनेशंस, व्हेन यू गो फॉर रिपीटेड एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ अ ट्रू इनसेन उसको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगा क्योंकि वो एक्चुअली उसमें प्रॉब्लम इज देयर। नॉट वरीड अबाउट बीइंग रिपीटेडली एग्जामिन्ड, बट व्हेन यू सी इन अ फीन इनसेन there will be always a different behavior every examination. Reasons for fear of being detected, kyunki iske zehen mein khauf hai ki wo pata chal jayega is cheez ka na ji. Bachcho yahan tak I think aapko har cheez clear honi chahiye, you can differentiate between true and insane insanity. Take some rest, please.
Thank you.
My sir.